How's it going, everybody? Welcome back to another show. This is You May Roscoe and I Am Roscoe. And today's show, we're going to be doing part two of some commentary. Actually, I did part one of this reaction already of Elvis Presley and the Black community. This is part two of that. I wanted to continue to hear like some dialogue about, you know, people who were close to Elvis Presley, people who are sharing their thoughts about the person that he was. So I wanted to continue that. But before we do, I do want to ask for anybody who hasn't already that they please subscribe to the channel. Also, make sure you hit the notification bell. That way you'll be reminded of future shows every time they're published. And let's go ahead and dive into this.
Welcome back, you guys, to the S&M Squad. It's your boy Sean
and your girl Mel.
Your favorite couple, y'all.
Yes, we are.
Definitely make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And don't forget to hit the notification bell so you'll be notified.
And guys, don't forget to join the S&M Squad.
Yes, sir. Whoa, Nelly.
The first time I met Elvis, I was in Las Vegas in the 70s. I was the conductor and music director for B.B. King, the blues act. We were opening in the Las Vegas Hilton's main room as the opening act for him. Well, we had no idea Elvis was there, nor did she. So we were watching her act from backstage. And in her act, she walked around the main room in the audience, and she always stopped at this certain table.
That morning, when I walked into the dining room, I spoke. I said, good morning. He said, good morning. I said, what are we going to have for breakfast this morning? He said, fried peanut butter and banana sandwich. And I looked at him. I said, what? He said, fried peanut butter and banana sandwich.
That actually sounds very good. That is a dope combination. I love bananas and I love peanut butter. But yeah, no, that is a bomb sandwich. And I've heard the legend of that sandwich, you know, which is, it is crazy how remarkable a person's legend could be, that somebody like me, who's was decades removed from like his real glory, you know, even though I think he passes while I'm still, you know, I was born and here on the earth as he had passed, you know, but that's the tail end. And of course I'm like a baby, so I'm, you know, but yeah, no, it's incredible how somebody's legend like his could reach, even into this day. I mean, the fact that this is 2022 and, you know, Elvis's heydays is really in the 50s, in the 60s, you know, so yeah, no, it's incredible that we're still talking about this guy. He's as revered as he is and all that stuff. You know, I marvel at that type of stuff, you know, a little bit, but let's keep it going.
I said, I never heard of it. The first time I went in, fixed the sandwich and put it on the tray and brought it back, that wasn't right. His father was sitting there, and he said, Mary, I'm going with you and help you. And let's see, maybe both of us can get it right. I said, okay. And he said, let's toast the bread first. So we toast the bread and then spread the peanut butter on and slice the bananas and put on and put them into the skillet and kept turning them with the spatula and turn them till they got heated all the way through. Then I take them and cut them, put them on the platter and take them back to me. And he said, that's what I want, that's right. And then smile.
Life, but he'll always live because of the fact he was such a beautiful man. I don't care what nobody say, I know Elvis. You know, there are a lot of rumors. Elvis and I sang spiritual together. And, he kept me from being number one. I was number one soul and he was number one world. And it took a long time, but it's almost like the two rental cars. Uh-huh. It made me try harder. And I love Elvis for it. And we'll always pray for Elvis.
Do you remember that? Do you remember?
I got to stop it for a second. You know, when James Brown speaks, it resonates, you know, even when you don't understand him as, you know, comedians would later, you know, joke about. He said some stuff right there. You know, he said something to the fact that, you know, Elvis being, you know, like the king of his world, you know, and James Brown is basically, you know, the king of soul, the king of funk, all that stuff, you know, the fact that they collide, they had the understanding that they had, the mutual respect that they had for each other. James Brown, he knew, you know, he's somebody, you know, like connected with the culture for real, you know, at that, especially during his younger days, you know. So I would like to think that James Brown would have the wherewithal to be able to pick up on Elvis's energy if it was anything other than righteous. You know what I mean? You know, I thought that was dope, but let me keep this going. And that looked like Whitney Houston right there. Let me see what she got to say.
Remember, it wasn't actually, you don't really meet Elvis, uh-huh. You actually just look at Elvis. Okay? My mother sang with Elvis for years.
Yeah.
She and her group, they were called the Sweet Inspirations. Yeah. They also sang for Aretha for many, many years. On most of the, in the 60s, they were on all of Aretha songs. Well, Elvis took a liking to them, mm-hmm. and my mom sang with him for many years. And they were very close.
Yeah.
I just remember at one point being in a room, and we were all in this room, my mother and the singers, and the usually backstage kind of thing, and he just walks in the room with his mink on, with his glasses on.
Oh, my God.
And he just walks in, he says something, and everybody just, you don't say anything, you just look. It was just one of those moments I won't forget as a kid.
Oh, my God.
It wasn't
God.
Like, hi, Mr. Elvis, nice to meet you. You didn't do that. You just sat back and just looked at him.
Amazing.
Amazing to look at.
Yeah.
Just amazing.
Wow.
And just to be in his presence was awesome.
Tell me about that.
That was dope to him. You know what I mean? Like, I didn't even realize, like, that Whitney Houston's mom, she had the pleasure of singing for Aretha and Elvis, you know, singing with them, you know. But that's, man, the stories that, you know, that the mom could tell, or if Whitney was still here, man, you know, because I mean, you know, that's a story I've never heard before, but let's keep it going.
Well, when they first called, the girl said, Elvis.
Oh, that's a long
life. My God, what are we going to do? I said, hey, it's a gig and it's a good one.
Uh-huh.
That's our mom like that?
We went. And when we got there, it was nothing like what we might have thought, you know, because it was just wonderful. Well, it was really wonderful. He was into gospel. So every once in a while when we finished rehearsing with him, we just sing gospel, all of us, you know. And we just had a good time. He would get good money and good pay and good, it was a nice atmosphere, you know, and we didn't go around with him as his friends. We worked for him. So we saw him at work or at rehearsals. So I don't know what he did in between, nor did I care. You know, mm-hmm. I just doing what I was supposed to do, and we were.
Back in them days too, and let me find out, Elvis. Let me find out.
Sweetness.
ticket too, just to make sure we didn't miss anything. Plus, I love the fact that they playing, you know, the soul music while Elvis is, you know, with the big afro in the screen and whatnot. Yeah, that is dope.
The Sweet Inspirations.
We've talked on television and had interview situations. I've never asked you about Elvis.
What you want to know?
When did that all start? When did the whole love for Elvis begin?
He teases me about Elvis all the time.
But never on the air.
No, well, he says, like, if Elvis was alive now, he says, man, you wouldn't even hang out with Elvis. I said, yes, I wish it, man. Elvis would be in the lobby of your house, like, say, man, is Eddie there? And I'd be in the room, tell him I'm out of here. Hey, what's going on, man? He told me to come over. Well, I know what's going on. All right. But when I was a kid, see, Elvis Presley to me, it's his presence, I think it is. I don't think anyone in this business has had as much presence as Elvis. I don't think anyone's had as strong a presence. I think there have been entertainers. I think Michael Jackson's the only entertainer who's ever been more famous than him. But I think Elvis has.
I didn't want to stop Eddie. I'm gonna push it back a little bit too, but yeah, no. I was just about to say, like, the only thing I could think of is Michael Jackson. You know, and he said it, you know, but I wouldn't know because I've never been around either, but I've seen it, you know, on film, you know, like, or just hearing how people still react to Elvis right now or Michael Jackson. You know what I mean? There's people that still revere these dudes like crazy, crazy, you know, so let's continue.
I'm over. Well, I know what's going on. All right. But when I was a kid, see, Elvis Presley to me, it's his presence, I think it is. I don't think anyone in this business has had as much presence as Elvis. I don't think anyone's had as strong a presence. I think there have been entertainers. I think Michael Jackson's the only entertainer who's ever been more famous than him. But I think Elvis has more present, like when Elvis walked in the room, everybody just looked at Elvis, you know, when he's on the screen, you looked at Elvis, he just had this thing about him, and he was going through all this stuff with drugs and all this craziness, but on screen and on stage, he always looked like he was in control, you know, and that's amazing, because it was this war going on inside this guy, and I'm just fascinated.
You know, because the black community obviously felt that we shouldn't be doing it, so Ebony Magazine, in fact, called us and wanted to know, we got a lot, why are you singing with Elvis Presley? You know, why not? and sometimes we get shot back with, well, you know what he said about black people.
I'm gonna push this back a second or two. She was just throwing me out because she got that little heroin itch, you know, but And I mean, I'm not saying that to try to, you know, demean her. You know, I just speak it. I mean, people who know me, you know, they would know. Like, I'm just raw and unfiltered like that. You know, I just kind of say it, but you know, but that it is what it is. You know, and I just say what it is. But she rocking out with the little Elvis. Yeah. Well, I'd see it because it was glittering. Let's keep this moving.
We got a lot. Why are you singing with Elvis Presley? You know, why not? and sometimes we get shot back with, well, you know what he said about black people. Yeah, I heard that story too. But I also heard the one he said about Mexican people. It's the same story. What he said about the story is Elvis Presley said, all a black person, I'm using that, can do for me is shine my shoes. Mexicans have the story, all a Mexican can do for me is sign my shoes. That's also attributed to Elvis. Yeah, that's a story, that's a rumor made up by some rock and roll singer who wanted to be where Elvis was, I suppose. Because as far as I'm concerned, Elvis treated us royally. And if he said it, I don't care, because there's things that I've said I don't want anybody repeating.
I'm going to be Elvis.
I just wanted to speak on that for a second. That is, I mean, let's say that Elvis did say that, you know, just for the sake of argument. Let's say that Elvis said something like, a black person couldn't do nothing for me but shine my shoes. Me, I'm in the mindset of, you know, a person's words are their words, and words are powerful, you know, and all that. But I do believe, you know, that a person's actions, and I know for as a matter of fact that people's actions sometimes tell a bigger story than the words do. You know, duality is a real thing, you know, and you know what's crazy when I think about that? I think about a character like Archie Bunker, you know, who, if you know, from the outside looking in, you know, just on a basic level, a guy that was considered a racist guy and all this and that. But if you really looked at that character in depth, you know, he was really, it was really a tale of like a lot of white guys who just kind of went with the flow, you know, and in their heart, they didn't really feel like, you know, like they wanted to make it us here and them there, but that was just how, that was just a sign of the times. A lot of those dudes, is it wrong to still move in that way? Yes, it is. I believe that. But the fact that it's not in their heart, you know, and their actions would say, you know, different things a lot of the time, you know, and that again, I brought that up for the sake of argument, but that was rumor. I wasn't around at that time, so I don't know, but I do think that people could, you know, all of us say racist. I've said racist stuff, you know, people, things that people could consider prejudice or racist or whatever. But I think people say that we just speak like that, you know, a lot of the time. And I think, it, you know, a person's actions will speak different. But if they were speaking like that, like, and it's a certain kind of way you talk about that stuff too, where you'll be like, nah, I could tell that's different from just somebody who just saying some stuff. But let's keep it going.
Impersonator.
Obviously, you see the irony here. You've got a black man.
I feel like I missed something with that last person. Let's take it back.
Elvis treated us royally. And if he said it, I don't care, because there's things that I've said I don't want anybody repeating.
I'm going to be Elvis impersonator.
Obviously, you see the irony here. You've got a black man imitating a white man who sounded like a black man.
I respect Elvis for what he did for music. You know, he opened a lot of doors for a lot of folks back there during a time when they wouldn't even, quote unquote, play the music on radio. So this is a tribute to Elvis.
That guy looks just like Elvis, you ask me. I mean, spit an image. So I don't see why people are tripping.
At first, yes.
Yeah, I mean, they said he's playing black music. He's a white guy.
Yeah, but see, at first he was playing more like rockabilly. He wasn't really getting into the things that he started to do later. But when he started to do that, then he started to turn heads, including mine.
Yeah, it did? So what did you see then?
I saw that he was, he had everything. The looks, he had the talent.
He had the rhythm,
everything.
Had the rhythm,
he had
the soul.
He had everything. To me, he had everything. You know, you started looking at the guy, God almighty, he's handsome, he's tall, and he looks good, he can sing, he can play.
He got a lot of women.
I didn't see you know, I didn't see women disliking him, but he was just, I didn't see him after them either. But I guess had I been handsome like that, I probably would have.
Pizza Hut stuffed crust is the crust that made crust good. I'm hungry.
Kill germs on hard or soft surfaces. New Clorox disinfecting mist. Shop now.
All right, wait a minute. Let me stop it. Because BB King. You know, and you know, it's easy to see. Like, I mean, even for me, I was able to see that as a kid. You know, like, that's what attracted me to, I wasn't attracted to Elvis, you know, but just his talent and him as a talent. Like, you couldn't do nothing but be in awe of that talent, you know. So when I saw him on TV as a kid, you know, reruns of movies and stuff like that, I was just like, dang, you know, this dude, he is like a dude. You could tell, like, he can get chicks. You know what I mean? He seemed real cool. He's singing, dancing. You know what I mean? Like, he did have it all, you know, but let's keep it moving.
Black cats, keep away from me. Take my advice. Go shinny up a tree. I've got a hard luck, the hardest kind of luck you'll find. I ain't lying. I've got the bluest kind of blue.
In the 60s and early 70s, when tensions between blacks and whites were at an all-time high, Elvis demonstrated his desire for racial reconciliation in the musicians that he chose and the treatment they received.
He believed that he had a certain connection with God, not so much more than anybody else did, but in his search, he was trying to get close to God. So he felt that by helping others, maybe that was his mission.
Different than other kids I grew up. I was an old girl in a younger state, it looked like.
Grew up with. I'd hang around parts of Tupelo my folks never even knew about. If Mama had known where I was half the time, I would have called hell for it.
The audio is just long. That's part of the end of the video. So.
This friend of mine used to take me across town to an area called Shake Rag.
Yeah, I'm stopping. I was talking over it a little bit. So we only got a little bit further to go before it's over. So.
This friend of mine used to take me across town to an area called Shake Rag. And that was when I first heard the blues.
This is the house that Elvis bought for me. He bought it in 1974. And he came at
Special year, my birthday.
Elvis bought for me. He bought it in 1974. And he came and picked the house out for me. And I liked it, and he liked it. So he said, well, Mary, this is your house, if you like it. I told him I loved it. It was really nice.
There must be lights burning brighter somewhere. Got to be birds flying higher in a sky more blue. If I can dream of a better land where all my brothers walk hand in hand, tell me why, oh why, oh why can't my dream come true?
Cancel. There we go. All right, so that was Elvis Presley and the Black Community Part 2. And that was people just sharing some of their thoughts on what they thought about him and his character. You know, I thought that was some good stuff to be said. And it's good to hear that from people who, you know, some people who are a little closer to the situation, you know, people who actually were around him, met him, close to him, you know, and stuff like that. But yeah, no, we make mistakes as people, you know, not to say that anything about some of the remarks and rumors about this guy was found to be true or nothing like that, because I don't think they was. But those rumors, they gonna still be out there, because people are just stupid, you know, and they gonna think what they think. But if you really think about it, man, and it's like what I said, you know, people and their actions are really tell the whole story for real, or tell the real story, I should say, you know. But I don't want to ramble. I just want to say that this was good. And I don't need to put a thumb up, but I will, you know, just to say it was good to check this out. So, so that's pretty much it. Before I get up out of here, like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell, hit the share button, playlist option, pick the one name, Elvis Presley Reactions, you're watching. Like them. Make sure you're not requesting anything that hasn't been reacted to already. It's early for me. I'm still trying to clear this mud, clear my throat. But I do have playlists for other artists as well. So check out all that stuff. The Cash App is on the screen. It's camouflaged a little bit, but it's $ You Made Roscoe. And that's Roscoe with a K. You know, people, even though they see the K all the time, you know, people are still putting C in there. It's Roscoe with a K, you know. But that's it. So time to go. But I will see you guys again soon. So until next time, y'all be good.